Thank you for inviting me, Arupda. I'm just going to answer one simple question, because whenever we present on capsule tension rings and segments, people say, how do you decide whether a capsule tension ring alone is going to be enough, or I need something sutured support, which is usually a capsule tension segment in my case, but there are other devices available. The answer I'm going to give you, using very short video clips, is that you don't need to make that decision before the case, or even before you put it in. You can make it step by step. And that is what zonular analysis intraoperatively means. This device you're familiar with is ICAMED's capsule tension segment, which is a brilliant device. And I usually almost always use it in combination with a capsule tension ring. And it is sutured using 9-O-proline, usually through a Hoffman pocket or through sterile flaps, which we tend to avoid these days because they melt with time. So the combination of the two devices will give you a graded stepwise approach to getting things done. This is a normal case, you know, easy case, soft case. I'm just doing my rexis. Just as I go there, I see, oops, something's not right. I probably lost zonule, or maybe the zonule was weak there anyway. I said, I'll proceed. I put a iris hook to support the support the capsular rexis, and then I'm doing very gentle rexis, tiny, tiny bits of rexis, and I think I'll empty the bag. But as I'm emptying the bag, that zonular dehiscence is increasing. So there must have been something, I think, preoperative, because I'm being very gentle here. So there must be some zonular loss. And it's not uncommon. In my practice, the most common reason for zonular loss is that it was pre-existing, but you didn't find it on slit lamp examination, because it's not always obvious. At that point, I put in my CTR, because what happens as you empty the bag becomes floppy and it will come into your phaco probe. So you need to stretch the bag as well as support it. So I put in my CTR, and I'm not worried about leaving cortical matter. I can clean cortical matter around the CTR and finish the case. Now the thing you will notice here is that that CTR is visible. It's visible around the edge there, which means to me now that that CTR is not going to be enough. Because a perfectly centered bag, the CTR should be under the iris. It should not be visible. So I then decide in my stepwise approach to put in a capsule tension segment. So the capsule tension segment goes in. This is a slightly old video, so there's a scleral flap we made. But I'll show you Hoffman pocket in the next minute video. The segment is placed in the area of maximum zonular loss. And the little C comes in front of the capsular rexis, obviously. And then you pass your 9-O-proline sutures, and then you go in and finish your case. So if you can think in stepwise manner, if that ring had been perfectly centered, I wouldn't have bothered with the segment. Because that ring was not perfectly centered, I said, no, it needs a segment, let's put a segment in. The beauty of the segment is it doesn't have to be rotated, unlike a Sioni ring, which I'll come to in a minute. So you can just ram it up against where you want it rather than causing additional shearing by turning this ring around again. So there we go. We finished. I'll cut off that case for the interest of time. Another one, simple case, soft lens. I'm even going to do a limbal relaxing incision because I want to take his astigmatism away. And I think, oh, this is a cakewalk. You know, nothing to it. Well, it's not nothing to it. The moment I put in viscoelastic, you see what happens. He's lost. He doesn't have zonule on the temporal side. The moment I fill with viscoelastic, that's healed on GV. If you find that, so we do the same thing again. Iris hooks to support the capsule. Capsule tension ring, a normal capsule tension ring, because I'm undecided whether I want to suture or not. So normal capsule tension ring goes in. I always feed them in bimanually, because the last thing you want to do is that trailing segment going into the anterior chamber because it slipped. So I have one instrument holding the trailing end, and then another instrument tapping it into the bag. And then once we finish the phaco, and then I've just edited it out in the interest of time, we put a capsule tension segment in place there. And here I've made a Hoffman pocket. I'd already made an incision for an LRI. So we just make a pocket which is edited out again, because we have strict 6-minute instructions. But the way to suture it is to pass your needle through and through, and then take a loop out of the pocket. And then you pass your other needle through and through, through sclera, through conjunctiva, take it out, cut it, throw it away, and pull the loop out. So you have two ends coming out through the pocket, which you then tie, and that suture disappears. You've not used diathermy, you've not used the flap, and you get a perfectly centered lens. I try and always use a three-piece lens. I always have a three-piece backup lens, which goes back if you don't need it. Because that is my insurance policy. If later on I need something, then I can go back and suture it or something. And finally, this is a Sioni ring just to show you in a very similar case why I do not prefer to use the Sioni ring. It's a much more rigid device. The process of fusing that segment makes it a much more rigid device. So I've got to put it in. I've threaded my 9-0 proline in. I'm struggling to get it in without causing too much damage or destruction. I've got two instruments in. Even then, the edge goes into the anterior chamber angle. I go in and reach for it, and I get it into the bag. Well, my job is not done yet, because then I have to now, once it's gone into the bag, I have to now rotate that to the area where I want to suture it. And you can imagine this rigid thing rotating, causing additional shearing. In my mind, it causes additional shearing. So you might be actually weakening more zonules rather than protecting them. So I'd rather use the segment, which is a small device, which can just go in, not pushing on zonules anywhere and being rammed up. And then you suture it just like the other case. So that was the main point I wanted to make, really, is that you can use a stepwise approach, use one thing at a time till you reach your end point. Thank you.